the previous video, we saw how the data from SQL Server can be loaded into Power BI using direct query. We are currently in the report view. So, we are currently in the report view where we can generate visualization. But before that, let's head over to data view and click on Amazon Box. And we can easily see now we will try to access video games here. So before proceeding, I'm going to tell you the topic name is building a visual with direct query in Power BI. Now let's head back. And if we are trying to access video game sales, see, by just clicking out of it, we will be given a message, this table use direct query and it cannot be shown in import mode. So we need to query to access it. One way to do it is to build visualization which uses the information in the video game. So let's head over to the report view. From here we will create a visualization. Okay, now we will highlight a clustered column chart, one that is in place, just expand it so that it is a little bigger. So we will just hit here to this clustered column chart and we will try to do it to a little bigger so we can have a clear picture. So now we will have some similarity to what we built previously. In the genre column will be here that genre column will be on the x-axis, that is each bar will represent a specific value of genre. As per the height, this will represent Japan sales and we will use Japan sales and here this one. And you will see that the bar chart for different genre in Japan. So we will put x-axis. So genre on x-axis and on y-axis we will put Japan sale. So what we will do, see, and on y-axis, okay. So you can see in details, let's okay. Okay, to go to the maximum label, we will go to the focus mode. Now you can see in detail that sales varied from each genre. We can start with adventure genre, which is this one, as a record lowest sale, which is 2.69 million, and this of course a single game at which we look at little earlier. The tallest bar represents here the role playing game. While in different view, we cannot see the raw data in video game sales. In the data view, when we generate a visualization from this data, the information is accessible. And this is because when we took a place on visualization, a query is made to the underlying database in the order to retrieve the data and then generate the visual. Next, let's head over to the SQL Server database and try to modify the value corresponding to the Japan sales for adventure game. So now go to the SQL Server instance here and what we will do, we will write down a query here which will update the video game sales. Then what we will do, we will do update dbo dot video game sales here and we will set JP sales equal 10 and we will set filter genre where adventure JP sales is equal where JP sales is equal to genre should be adventure. This is the modification we are doing. So when we execute this query, an update has been made here, and to confirm this, let's return the select query we just saw before. So we will select it and we'll go with execute. Then we will say JP sales has been set here to value 10. So we take a look at the sales adventure game again, that it's just a single row, but significantly the JP sales column has now been updated from the previous value of 2.692 to 10. So how exactly do we get this in Power BI Desktop? Well, heading back to it, the adventure genre is not really updated. This is because Power BI Desktop works a little bit differently in the Power BI service, where your end user viewing the reports each time they load a report. Well, direct query will send the query to the underlying database and will query the underlying database and will retrieve the data latest value. The Power BI service is not something that we will cover in this learning path. It is still important for you to know as a data analyst how you can pull in all of the latest information into Power BI Desktop. Effectively forcing a refresh of the cache, well, for that you can just hit the refresh button, and then from the dialog which pops up, you will observe that all of the table now has been refreshed to the latest contents, and soon enough the graph also sets to the updated. So guys, you can see that adventure, if you hover over adventure, you can see the sum of JP sales has been updated to the 10, which is now at the middle of the chart and at the end. And sure enough, the JP sales number is the updated value of 10. Had you been by Power BI service, this change has been picked up each time report has been loaded. Since it performed direct query each time the report has been loaded, but in the case of import mode, it may take a little longer to push to the local cache, in which case you may be served stale data. Now we will cover one more feature related to the different storage mode, for which we can hand over to the model view. When we select video game sales here properties, so when we select video game sales from here in the model view, properties span will, so guys, if you select video game sales here, properties span will pops up. It is possible to us to change the associate mode with it. So specifically when we expand advanced, there is a you will notice that there is a storage mode. There is a single setting for storage mode, and yes, of course it has been set to direct query for video games, but it is possible for us to change here. So if we go here, we can see we can select it to the import to the dual mode. Dual mode allows us to cache some data but not all of it, effectively serving as a hybrid between import and direct query mode. Now however, let's see what will happen if you switch over to from direct query to the import mode? Well, we can notify, we are notified that this change is permanent. So it is possible for us to switch from direct query to import mode, but reverse we can't, and it cannot be done. Once the data set has been loaded into Power BI desktop in the import mode, we don't have option to switch back to direct query mode. So make sure this is a change you want to go through. This I am just going to hit OK storage mode. And soon enough it will take effect. Now we are having little more familiarities with storage mode available in Power BI. So friend, this is all about in my video. Thank you.